Our next speaker this morning is Catherine Ringelberg from Troy, Ontario. She has been competing in the Canadian Young Speakers for Agriculture competition since she was 16, and this is her final year in the competition. She works for Holstein Canada, coordinating the classification program. She lives on her family's dairy farm where they milk approximately 60 cattle. Her speech topic this morning is how can we improve the media's perception of Canadian agriculture? Let's give a warm welcome to Catherine.
Excuse me, ma'am? Can you tell me what this label means? It says this product is certified humane. And what about this one? It says this product is antibiotic free. What does this all mean anyways? Honorable judges, ladies, gentlemen, and fellow competitors, the trip down the grocery store aisle is not a simple thing anymore. The truth is, most consumers do not have a clue why the products on the store shelf are labeled the way they are. Instead, they fall victims to the media's campaigns against the agriculture community. Just think of the examples today. A&W's Better Beef campaign, and Chef Jamie Oliver now fronts Sobeys Certified Humane program. And it's not just these companies we have to worry about. Perhaps the more damaging images that falsely depict agriculture have come from groups like PETA and Mercy for Animals. It seems everywhere you turn, you can find a campaign that scrutinizes and incriminates the farmer. Let's not forget the damage that social media has done. There are 2.34 billion people on social media sites worldwide. Twitter has 313 million users who are active every month. Ellen DeGeneres has almost 64 million Twitter followers. Why is this important, you wonder? Because Ellen, like so many others, is a very vocal vegan. Ellen was quoted as saying, "They are all in pain. They are all suffering. They are all diseased, and they are all treated with antibiotics." Ellen says this, and it reaches all of her followers. And just like Ellen, not all of these people are able to differentiate the truth from the lies. Now, I don't know about you, but I do not have anywhere near 64 million Twitter followers, but I do have something that Ellen does not, and that is a firsthand knowledge of agriculture. Just a few short weeks ago, I spent the day at the Rockland World's Fair looking after the dairy heifers. During this time, I had people of all ages approach me and ask me questions about the animals. What surprised me most were not the questions themselves, but rather the simple fact that many of these consumers had never met a farmer before. You see, we have many consumers, and our consumers all have notions and ideas about what agriculture entails. Today, they get these ideas from the media. But what would happen if we were to meet with our consumers? For the people in my story, I am now the face of all dairy farmers. And the more faces of farmers that these individuals could meet, the more likely they are to trust the farmer. The problem is that 80% of Canadians now find themselves living in cities. Many no longer have family involved in farming operations. Therefore, they do not know any farmers. We need to invite our consumers to breakfast on the farm, dinner on the dairy, our local fairs. Do you have friends who are confused about what you do? Why not invite them over for a day and have them tag along with you while you work? I encourage you to approach a local school and host a field trip to your farm. All of these are examples of opportunities we can give to those not familiar with agriculture. Opportunities that would allow for them to meet with the farmer, to ask us their questions, and to most importantly, put a face to the person who grows their food. To go alongside face-to-face communications, we need to utilize social media platforms. So often we as farmers are guilty of only posting on social media in defense of what we do. But why do we wait that long? Why are we not starting more conversations? How many of you have Facebook, Instagram, Twitter? How many of you utilize it to make weekly or even daily posts about what is happening on the farm? What is holding you back? We all remember the significant impacts that the hashtag Farm365 campaign had on our industry. You have your phone, pick it up. Make that post, send that tweet. Remember, it is the reputation of our industry on the line. And it is time we rewrite what is being said about us. It is time we stand up tall and we tell our stories. Together, we are going to change the media's perception of food and agriculture, one consumer at a time. Because if our consumers believe us, the media will start to as well. After all, our consumers, are they not the 98% of the population who drive what the media says about us? I recognize the negative impacts that the media has had on our industry. Yet I have chosen to work in this sector. Why, you ask? For me, it is simple. What A&W, Ellen, and the animal activists all failed to recognize when creating their campaigns against us was that they are dealing with the most resilient group of people in the world. Farming is our passion. It is in our blood. And these campaigns, they are not going to lessen that passion for agriculture. They will only encourage us to tell our stories a little bit louder. Together, we can work to ensure that the next time that consumer goes down a grocery store aisle to see the hormone-free product, they just keep on walking because they know and they trust the farmer who grew their food. Thank you.